In this video, we're going to practice using our tools, our ruler, our protractor, and our compass to rotate this triangle around this point O. So the thing that we are going to do is that we're going to rotate this triangle around the point O. We're going to go counterclockwise 80 degrees. So the first thing that I'm going to do is label each of the points of the triangle. Tends to make it just easier to talk about what's happening. So when I rotate, the goal is to make an angle with center O for each of these points on the triangle so that the original point and O and the new point form this 80 degree angle. So the first step that I'm gonna take, and we're gonna start with point A, just because I labeled it A, and I'm gonna draw a line from A to O using my ruler. And then the thing that I want to do is measure an angle of 80 degrees. So I need my protractor and I'm going to line this up to measure an angle. So I need the center of the angle to be in the hole of my protractor. And I need this line to be lined up with this bottom line on the protractor. And then I need to measure from here 80 degrees. So 80 degrees looks like it's this one. Remember, I need 80 degrees starting from zero on this side, so I need the numbers that are 10, 20, 30, 40, the smaller numbers on the bottom this time, not the bigger numbers on the top. That would be if I started from over here and measured past 90 degrees. So remember to think about that with your angles. So then I'm going to take and use my ruler to draw a straight line from O through this point. So this is going to be an 80 degree angle. I'm going to draw a nice long line. The other thing that we need to be true is that we need this distance from O to A to be the same distance as from O to the image of A. So I could do that with my ruler, I could measure, but I'm actually gonna use my compass in this case, and I'm gonna open it so that the pointy end of the compass is on O and the pencil end is on A. And then as long as my compass is behaving, I'm gonna draw a circle like this. And the reason that I do that is that all the points on this circle are the exact same distance from O. That's the definition of a circle. So A is the same distance from O as any of these points. But in particular, the point that I'm interested in is this one over here, which is on this line. And so now I'm going to label this point A with a funky hat on. I like to label them A with a funky hat on so you can see it's like A, but not the same as A. You can call it anything else that you want to. Probably I wouldn't use B or C or A or O since those are already used, but anything else will do. I like A with a hat on it. And now I can see that if I measure with my protractor, the angle from A to O to A with a hat on it is 80 degrees. So this point A has been rotated 80 degrees. And now I'm gonna do the exact same thing, but with B and with C. So let's use a different color to draw this line from B to O. I'm gonna draw a dashed line this time just so that it starts getting a little bit less busy, as little busy as possible. There's just a lot going on here. So again, I'm gonna put O in the center of my protractor and this orange line on the bottom line of my angle. And then I'm gonna measure 80 degrees, which is here. And then I'm gonna draw another dashed line. Like so. Make a nice long line so that I have enough space to do what I'm doing. And then again, I need, so this angle now is 80 degrees. So we can mark it 80 degrees if we want to. That's probably really tiny, but it says 80 degrees. I'm just trying not to make the drawing any more busy than it needs to be. So then again, I need this distance from O to be exactly the same as O to the image of B. So again, I'm gonna put the pointy end of my compass on O, the pencil end on B. Hope my compass behaves well enough and draw a nice circle. It's almost the same radius as the one with A, but not quite. And so then I'm gonna draw this point right here. All these points are the same distance from O to B as any point on the circle. So this one right here is gonna be B with the hat on it, the image of B. And then finally, let's do the same with C. So again, I need to draw a line. Maybe we can make a dotted line from O to C. I need to measure an 80 degree angle. So I put the center of my protractor on O and I line up this line. Maybe I need to make it a little bit longer so that I can see it at the back of my protractor. There, that should do it. Yep, now that's good and lined up. Make my mark at 80 degrees. Go ahead and draw my dotted line. Nice and long so that I can have enough space to work with. And then finally, I use my compass to get this distance from O to C. Pointy end on O, pencil end on C. Hope the compass works well enough. And draw, oop, it slipped. Pretty common. It can be easier to turn the paper than the compass sometimes, so let's go ahead and do that in this case. Okay, now every point on this circle is the same distance from C, from O to C. And so the intersection here of my dotted line and the circle should be where the image of C ends up. So now I've rotated A over here, B over here, and C over here. And what that actually is gonna do is, because rotations preserve distances, this line from A to C, this line from A to the C are the same distance. And so if I rotate this entire line, it's gonna end up over here between A hat and C hat. And so what I can do to finish this up is just connect the dots, A to C hat to B hat, and A hat to B hat as well. So all of the points now got rotated. So this triangle over here is the image under this rotation of this triangle over here. So if I looked at some point like this one, maybe 3/4 of the way between A and B, it would end up over here, 3/4 of the way between A hat and B hat. So there we have it. Thank you.